Most business owners know the importance of getting reviews, but I'm going to reveal some tactics that I use to get extra reviews and to get positive reviews, and also some things you may not have come across on other videos before. So for example, do you know what to say to get more reviews? And did you know there's a special label that goes on certain reviews? And also, did you know that negative reviews can be a good thing? Bill Gates is going to show you that in a moment. And as you'll probably know, getting reviews on a regular basis over time is a good thing. Well, I'm going to show you a tool that will show you how your competition's doing in that area and then helps you set a goal that's realistic for your particular type of business. So as part of this interaction, just tell me about your experiences when it comes to giving out comments and reviews down below. So just put a comment down below and tell me your experiences. Do you give reviews? Do you generally go 5-star? Do you give photos? Do you put details? Do you think of keywords for the people that you review? It's interesting how Google reviews have changed, because a few years ago, in the Google Plus days, anyone, anonymous, could put a review out on a business. Well, as you can imagine, that was misused quite dramatically by some companies. Imagine getting thousands of reviews for your company and all anonymous. So they realized quite quickly that you had to put an identity to the person that's reviewing you. So I mentioned the quality of empathy is needed when it comes to reviews. And here is just a few things you may want to consider before you respond to a review, whether it's positive or negative. Just think about empathizing for the person. So for instance, if they've put in a negative comment, think of it from their point of view and try and think about what you could do to make that into a positive. So personalize your response, put their name in there, restate what it is that they liked or didn't like from their comments. Then also value their feedback, thank them for it, regardless of whether it's positive or negative. And then show to them by your comments that you care, that you want to put things right. Apologize to them, even if you feel that it's not your fault. And then finally, try and resolve their problems and find a solution. Why those four things? Because they've been proven to produce positive results. Has to be said that if someone's given you a bad review, and maybe it's a 1 or 2-star review, if you resolve their problems, the likelihood is they'll upgrade that to a 4 or 5-star review. That's generally the way people work, because they recognize that they're not there to try and pull a business down, but they're there to just try and get a positive response to their concern or their problem. When you empathize with them, they feel you understand them. They'll then feel you're giving a great service, a customer service that's second to none. Okay, so what other things can you do to get plenty of reviews? Well, one of the most obvious ones is to go to all the other places where you've had reviews in the past. So maybe you've got reviews on LinkedIn, on Facebook, on Yelp. Well, why not go back to those happy clients from maybe a year or two ago, and on a regular basis, just go to those ones and ask them, would they mind updating it now on Google My Business? Because that's a platform you're currently using. The chances are they'll either just do that and they'll copy and paste what they've put in there, or maybe they'll rephrase it slightly. You can even ask them if they could perhaps include certain keywords if they felt appropriate. But what's the advantage of doing that over time? Well, if you just trickle in regular reviews every month, Google My Business algorithm loves that. And that's what you're aiming for here, is to try and get not a chunk of 100 reviews in one day, because Google will just go, that's just a spammy process. But what you want to do is just get it trickling in 2 or 3 a week, and Google loves that, and it sees it's relevant, it sees these are current, and it sees they're helping customers understand why you're authentic, why you're an expert, and why you're trustworthy. Another great way to get reviews is to just be helpful. So people ask questions. Quite often I get questions, and if it's something I can answer in a few moments, then I'll give them a response via email. I'll look at a screenshot for someone. I'll even look at their website just to see if I can give a little bit of an expertise eye on it. And if by helping people, if they then come back with a really positive response and they thank you, and perhaps they offer to even pay for the time you've taken, sometimes for 20 minutes time, it's not really an invoice, is it? So you could just say, well, I'll tell you what, would you mind just giving me a positive review? So if you're helpful, you'll find you'll often get reviews given you. Sometimes people offer a review, or they'll just give you a review and you didn't even expect it. And they're often the best ones, aren't they? Because you've not even asked for that review. If you do need to ask for reviews, then how do you go about that? Well, you might want to send an email that just makes it clear what you want. In fact, when I did a a video a few months back with LaRue Window Cleaning Services, we used a particular format that got some really positive reviews from his clients. Let me just share that with you. We said there, could you do me a favor? That being the title of the email. And then hi to the customer as you know them. Obviously you've got their name. As you probably know, I currently find work based on positive recommendations. As we, or I, have provided my cleaning services reliably for some time now, I hope you don't mind me asking for a quick favor. As you are aware, good reviews help other customers find my services. It would really help me out if you could give a brief review on my Google My Business entry. If you click on the link below, it will take you to the place where you can give a review. And of course, you can get that link then from your Google My Business listing. And then may I thank you in advance and hope you have a great weekend ahead. Now, what you notice here is it's, can you do me a favor? And it just feels positive, doesn't it? And actually, do you know, most people go, yeah, I can do you a favor. And they'll then write a positive review. Of course, do this to clients that are happy with you and that you know are going to respond well. And that's produced some great results over the last few months. The thing it's worth noting is Google wants you to get leads and wants you to get reviews. So Google's wanting reviews to come in on a regular basis. And you know that because Google makes it so easy to get that review link, because there it is. You can go into Google My Business and there you see the link to share to get reviews. But why does Google want this? Because Google knows that leads and referrals work on human beings. So as much as Google My Business might recommend something through Google Maps, ultimately people will respond to human reviews, human viewpoints. And that's what Google wants. It wants that human element to the Google My Business listing. But sometimes it's good to just ask yourself a few questions. We often say questions to be honest with. So this is questions now for your business. So think of your business, think about all the things you're doing, think about how people view it and how they review it. And then ask yourself this, how recent is your last review? So how long ago was it you had a review on your Google My Business listing? The second question, what can you do to get some reviews via your recent customers? So think about the customers you've had in the last few weeks. Maybe you finished some jobs, or maybe you finished a product or a service with someone. What can you do to get a review from them? And finally, have you tried a QR code to get reviews? So it could be that you could put this QR code on your business cards, and people will scan a QR code just to see where it leads to. But if it leads to the URL, the link to your Google My Business reviews, they may just then leave a review. So just think about different ways to get your reviews out there. So QR code is one way. But I mentioned earlier that negative reviews can be a good thing under certain circumstances. First of all, if they're genuine negative reviews because you've given poor service somewhere, then you can turn that into a positive. And that's where Bill Gates had perhaps a different view to what most people did around him, because he said, your most unhappy customers are your greatest source of learning. Just think on that for a moment. That's true, isn't it? That it could be that your unhappy customers are revealing something that actually you do need to learn from and you do need to improve in your business. So don't always respond negatively to negative reviews, because they may be revealing something that you need to look into. So I wanted to show you a free tool that I've been using recently that I found really helpful. So I'm going to put a link to it down below in the comments. So make sure you click on that and then try it out. It's free. It's a Chrome extension. And let me just show you how it works. So I'm here just doing a search for SEO Google London, just as a random business search. And you notice here Rapid SEO London comes up. But what it does do is these orange things are from this Chrome extension. So just in Google Maps, and I've got three things I can get from this. But particularly we're interested in how reviews work as well. So this is useful just to show me that they're categories. There's a primary category, the star one, and then there's a couple of other categories as well. So if you went through your competition, you might get an idea of what are the categories you want to use, but that's neither here nor there. What I'm interested in is, I know that they've got 52 reviews and an average of 4.9, but remember I mentioned earlier the importance of getting regular reviews in. Let me click on review audit, and that'll take a few moments. And what it does, it pulls up and looks, so you see it's working in the background here, looks at all their reviews, and as it goes through their reviews, it then graphs it. Now look at that. Now this is an SEO company, so they understand the importance of reviews. They've got 52 reviews, average of 4.9, And then you can see number of reviews provided by local guides. So they've got four there. We get a few bits of stats here. But what I'm interested in is look at how regular. That is just a beautiful line that's regularly going up. So every single month, every single week, it appears that they're getting decent reviews. So from 2015 to 2021, a nice steep line of regular reviews. I also mentioned that you can also get a label specially put on your Google My Business review if it's quite recent. And I'll show you what that means here. So we're just looking, so I'm doing a search for Gordon Ramsay's restaurant in London, and they've got quite a lot of reviews there, 1,500 plus reviews. But just notice, if you go to the reviews themselves, so you can click on here, for example, if you pull up the reviews, any new reviews gets a new label. So you notice they go straight to the top, but they've also got the word new. And that's generally if you've got a review in the last week or so. So there you go, 3 months is the next one, a month. So there's a kind of a general organization or an order that Google throws up, but it'll always put a new one first. So just a nice, if you do get the new review, it just keeps Google aware that you're relevant, you're fresh, your content's being consistently reviewed. And that's, again, a further proof the algorithm is enjoying getting regular weekly reviews, because it does give it a special label at the moment. So what are you going to do then with all this information? Well, you might think to yourself, I've already got several reviews, I've got some good reviews, but obviously you can increase the impact of reviews, particularly if you're getting regular ones coming in on a regular basis. So why not try this today? Get the Google My Business Everywhere tool, the link's down below, and run it and see what your competition's doing and see how regular they're updating, and then see if you can beat that. The second thing is check that you've responded positively to all your reviews. So you might look and find there's quite a few that you haven't responded to. So respond to them, thank them, be positive. And if there's been negative comments in the past, then see if you can put those right. You may find that even some of those negative reviews will turn into positive ones going forward. And then finally, set yourself a goal. So it might be that you use that everywhere, that GMB Everywhere tool. You see what your competition's doing. So set yourself a goal for reviews each month and then trickle them in. And you'll then find if you do those things, it's going to have quite an impact on your algorithm with Google, because Google at the moment is thoroughly rewarding reviews. And as we saw recently, reviews from customers with photos is a double whammy if you can get that too. But of course, it's not always just about reviews. It's also about communication through posts. And we've been building up some posts over the last few weeks. Do you know there's a very powerful type of post that we haven't covered yet? And I'm going to cover that with you in tomorrow's lesson. So I'll see you then.